While the Heisenberg, the Heisenberg's a German scientist, the Heisenberg picture of quantum mechanics is that wave function will remain static in time, means psi at no time, at time t0, and psi of t will remain the same, while the operator will not remain the same in time, means the operator will evolve in time. And then there is a picture, Dirac picture of quantum mechanics is that both wave function and operator will evolve in time. So he is stating a completely different picture, which is a combination of the Schrödinger and Heisenberg pictures of quantum mechanics. They both, not only the state but also the operator, evolve in time. So this is postulate 5, which is that state of a wave function will evolve in time, and it will satisfy the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation. Is the wave function was satisfying the time independent Schrödinger wave equation. And there is another postulate which we call the postulate 6, and that postulate 6 is actually, let me write the postulate 6, which I will not go in much detail because this is not commonly discussed, which is addressing the anti-symmetry principle, means the total wave function remains anti-symmetric. The anti-symmetric principle of a wave function, or the anti-symmetry of a wave function, the total wave function is anti-symmetric. This postulate actually gives the Pauli exclusion principle, but we will not go in much detail about postulate 6. So these are actually the postulates of quantum mechanics. We have done almost all of them, but we have not described them as like postulates. So in formalism of quantum mechanics, I just discuss them one by one. Now we will start with the quantum mechanics, and we will discuss the different notations here by just stating that in quantum mechanics, the state of a system is described by a wave function, and the observables are represented by operators. And the wave functions will have to satisfy some requirements, like if it is not time evolved, then it will satisfy the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, and if it is time evolving, then it will satisfy the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation. And as all the operators are acting linearly, so we will only restrict ourselves to the linear algebra, and the operators are to be Hermitian operators. So we start that only normalizable wave function represents a physical state. So in formalism of quantum mechanics, only normalizable wave functions will represent a physical state or a physical quantum mechanical state of a system. If they will not be normalizable, then they cannot represent a physical state of a system. And the set of all square integrable functions, it will be a finite thing, that from if we are having a function f of x, for a function or physical state psi or f of x, then the f of x will be such that if we take the mod square of it dx, then this will be less than infinity. It will be a finite thing, and it will all this set of all square states, they will constitute a Hilbert space. So we can say that the wave function we can also write in this form, minus infinity to plus infinity psi mod squared dx less than infinity, and it will constitute a Hilbert space. The inner product of two functions, the inner product which we also call the dot product, the inner product, dot product in case of vectors, the generalized means for a function we call this is inner product of two functions. Let's consider two functions, f of x and g of x. So we can write their inner product is from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x, and this will be conjugate, and g of x dx. We make this one conjugate because they are complex in nature, and their multiplication with a non-conjugate will actually make it real. So this dx we can represent in the is this f we write in a bra notation, and this g we write in a kit notation, and it is a representation, the Dirac representation of this thing is like this. So this we call is a bra, and this we call is kit. This is in the Dirac notation of quantum mechanics, and it is really easy to write this thing instead of writing them in integral, that they are the same thing if we write it in like this. So we write any function, if we write in this form, then it actually means the conjugate of this, in not only the conjugate but also the transpose of it in matrix terms, and g like this. So in matrix, if we are having a finite dimensional vector space, then the vector is expressed as column. For example, we are having a vector alpha, then we can write it in column representation A1, A2, A3, so on up to An. This is the column representation or matrix representation. And if I convert this alpha from the kit notation to a bra notation, then it will be like this alpha. And what will happen to this one? The column will actually change to a row because I will take its transpose, and it will become like this A1, A2, A3 and up to An, and I will have to take the conjugate of each because it is conjugate is with A's transpose of a matrix. So the ket notation like this is representing in column vector, and the bra notation will actually convert it into transpose is with A's conjugate. So we will have to understand this difference. And a function f of x is, or a function psi of x is said to be normalized, is said to be normalized if the inner product of this with itself is equal to 1, like minus infinity to plus infinity, f conjugate and f dx is equal to 1, which we can also write is f inner product with f is equal to 1. So this one we can also write is integral from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x mod square dx. So this is kind of representation, and two functions f of x and g of x will be orthogonal, will be orthogonal if their inner product f and g will be equal to 0. This I can write like this as well, minus infinity to plus infinity, and f conjugate and g with it and dx, and this will be equal to 0. So the orthonormality, to get the orthonormality means the orthogonal plus normalized. So orthogonal plus normalization, we can combine these two conditions and we can call this one is defined as orthonormal, means orthogonal and normalized. So I can write them in the bracket notation. If this is fn a function and this is fn, then this will be equal to delta mn, the Kronecker delta. If m and n will be the same, then we will get 1 here for m equals n, and we will get 0 for m not equals n. So m not equal n, this is the orthogonality condition, which is this one. And for m equal n, then this will be the same function then. So it will be the inner product of the same function and it will be equal to 1, and we call this the orthonormality condition. And the other thing, that the operators are to be Hermitian operators. So for an operator to be a Hermitian operator, we are having the condition that f, and let's say we are having operator q and it operates on f here, then this will be equal, if this comes into the bra here, means it comes here and it operates on this, and F here, then such means when the transpose and conjugate of it, when it comes here, it means it, we will get transpose of this one and the conjugate of this one. If the transpose and conjugate of it is the same, means the operator is not affected if we take the transpose of it or and we take the conjugate of it, then such an operator we call, the Q operator is called, Q is Hermitian operator. And Hermitian operators are having their specific properties. Similarly, expectation value of this we will write is F here. Means if I want to find the expectation value of Q operator, then I can write this is from minus infinity to plus infinity and a function, then Q here on a function and dx, then this thing I can write is the bra and then the operator and the ket notation of F, and these two are actually the same thing.